The Congress Party Vice President Rahul Gandhi has hit back after Jayanti Natarajan's revolt. Rahul Gandhi was addressing a rally in Delhi and he said, "Yes, I told Jayanti Natarajan to save the environment, to work for the poor and the downtrodden." Jayanti Natarajan had quit the Congress and launched a frontal attack on the Congress Party Vice President Rahul Gandhi, saying Rahul Gandhi had stalled the India growth story. She had honored every request that came in from Rahul Gandhi's office. Rahul Gandhi today reacted to this, says, "I have fought for the poor and the tribals. I told Jayanti Natarajan that we have to protect the tribals and the poor." Headlines today is Ashar Ahmed Khan joins me with the latest. Ashar, this was Rahul Gandhi batting on the front foot, extremely combative Rahul Gandhi, who said, "I am not here to do politics of the corporates. I am here to do politics of the poor."
Well, absolutely. In fact, we've seen since the time this story has come out, Rahul Gandhi has, and sources close to Rahul Gandhi have been very candid about this. They've categorically stated that Rahul Gandhi was batting for tribals, was batting for downtrodden, and that's why the letters he'd written and the emails he'd written. As far as the allegations are concerned, the allegations were that as an MP, there were representations which came to Rahul Gandhi, and Rahul Gandhi forwarded those representations which had come from several NGOs. So what the Congress party and people close to Rahul Gandhi have been saying is that the Congress vice president was making genuine requests. He was not interfering as for a particular lobby or a particular group. He was only trying to put across the point of the poor and the downtrodden. We've seen that this is the third outing of Rahul Gandhi in these assembly election campaigning which has been going on. In all these three rallies and outings, he's gone on to say that he is for the poor, the Congress party is for the poor. And in all these rallies and roadshows, he's attacked the Prime Minister, categorically stating that the Prime Minister Narendra Modi and his government have been working specifically for 4 or 5 industrialist houses who are also close friends of the Prime Minister. So that is the plank which the Congress party and the Congress Vice President has been taking. And categorically, it was a combative Rahul Gandhi, the Congress Vice President, hitting out, saying that he is there for tribals and that is why he is there in politics. He is the voice of the poor. So a very combative Rahul Gandhi at this time we saw.
Indeed, a very combative Rahul Gandhi, a different Rahul Gandhi that people saw today. But many analysts are now saying, isn't this too little and too late? Did he start off a little too late, Ashar?
Well, that is something which has been bothering the many Congress people also. In fact, they said that the entire strategy, entire campaign of the Congress party is perhaps something which happened a little too late. The announcement of Ajay Makan as the de facto chief ministerial candidate and also the chairman of the campaign committee, the coming of Rahul Gandhi and Sonia Gandhi on the Delhi election arena, this all just started, say, about a week back or so. The first rally, the first roadshow or outing of the Congress Vice President was last Monday, and today is Wednesday, just a little over a week. So that is how they've involved themselves. That is something, some sort of a criticism which is coming also from the Congress cadres and also from analysts. But the point, Gaurav, here is that deep down the Congress party also knows that this is not their game. This is something between Kiran Bedi and Arvind Kejriwal. But what they're doing all this to ensure the party cadre, the party organization stays in place, stays functional, which is very important for a political party which has been in power for 3 consecutive terms in Delhi.
And that would be a little disappointing for the Congress party. They held Delhi for 15 years and this time they're not even in the reckoning. The left came out openly and said, "We are supporting the Aam Aadmi Party." Prakash Karat went on record to say there are some voices within the Congress party that say, should push come to shove, the Congress vote can also be diverted towards the Aam Aadmi Party. Is this largely the thinking of the Congress party, or is this just a fringe within the party?
It's a very small fringe. At the moment, you know, there have been individual stalwarts which are not present in the national arena but in local areas who have done tremendous amount of work at their local level and are big leaders. So the Congress people winning assembly segments, assembly seats are going to be those individuals who've gone in every gully, every mohalla, who've stood for people in the last 15 years. So there is a battery of these these strong leaders at the local level, which the Congress party still has. Now, they are very keen and very interested in fighting elections, in keeping their cadres alive, in keeping the Congress organizational structure alive.
Yes.
So, that is what the Congress party is banking on. The old guard, the old cadres coming out, calling in all favors, calling in the kind of good work which they've done in their respective constituencies. And that should come to the aid of the parties. That is what the Congress is banking upon.
Ashar, the Congress party had 8 seats last time, and when you look at all the opinion polls that are coming in this time, that's not very flattering for the Congress party. How is the Congress reacting to these opinion polls? Will they be able to retain their numbers? What's the Congress party strategy, Ashar?
Well, we've seen the Congress party always says that they are not in favor of opinion polls and they never react to opinion polls. But the fact of the matter still remains, Gaurav, as we were discussing, that they've come in too late into this game. And the voter who would have gone to the Congress party, the Congress also feels is now shifting or tilting towards the Aam Aadmi party. And that is why we're seeing that in the opinion polls, the numbers are abysmal for the Congress party, even less than their all-time low performance in the last assembly election in Delhi.
Yes.
That is something which is worrying for the Congress party also, but it's the stiff upper lip which the Congress party has to keep. And as we were talking about, it's all about enthusing the cadres, getting the organizational structure in place and reviving it. That is what they're doing.
Ashar, keep tracking the Congress story. I will come back to you for more.